Today, I am thrilled to welcome KK and Manish Mistry to DTV. KK is a legend in DevOps circles. His achievements include creating Jenkins, the automator that people know and love around the world for setting up CI/CD environments. Teachable, a startup specializing in improving testing through machine learning. And we're going to learn a bit more about that during this interview. And then he's joined by Mistry, who is the CTO of InfoStretch. He drives the innovation, R&D, and exploration of next-generation technologies. So it'd be great to kind of start out for KK, first you, and then Manish, a little bit about your digital engineering journey. You know, what's caused you to spend your time and your life in such a difficult field?
What field does it mean? What, the DevOps and QA?
Well, DevOps and QA and digital in general, right? If it was easy, everybody could do it.
Actually, in that sense, I think it's not of all the things in my endeavors, I find this pretty easy, actually. You know, like, in fact, if anything, like coming to QA, I felt more of that, you know, like because programs, like in general, so deterministic and like attainable. You can redo it anytime you want. Like you can move around, and heck, you can even work from home.
Yes.
Like not many people have this kind of enviable passions.
So Manish, what's caused you to stay in this crazy field of ours?
Well, I would say digital is a amazing journey. I would say digital has become now life for everyone, right? Especially in these days.
Yes.
One cannot be more excited than this. That's good part is that our, as a computing life cycle, our innovation cycle has dramatically increased, changed. I would say computing power has dramatically changed. Our needs have changed. I mean, technically, you can see that our body itself is becoming a digital twin. That's what the information we are looking for up to that level. So I would say there cannot be better time than this about especially transforming the whole industry on a global level.
So KK, I'm really curious, you know, you spent, you know, Jenkins and DevOps was a whole new area, kind of pushing development into operations and blending things. What's caused you now to go focus on Launchable? Isn't like testing a solved problem? I mean, what's the point?
Yeah, I wish I had this like a nice cookie cutter answers, but I always kind of let my curiosity and interest drove me to Jenkins. Like it wasn't like I had any grand plan or like a big vision or like something that like makes other people aspire. Like I just wanted to write some freaking programs that on my spare time, and it just turned out to be more popular. As a part of this, being a Jenkins founder, like one of the few parks, if you can call it that, that is like wherever I go, like I can essentially broadcast like, hey, I'm in this city, like, you know, if you're doing software development, I'd love to talk to you, please have me in the office. And like the people just open up, you know, they let me have been there on site and they kind of dump on me all the challenges that they're working on. And
yeah, so many people complained about it. You said, well, there's got to be something to solve if this is the pain for so many people world.
Exactly. Yeah. And I can totally relate to that, right? As an engineer, I worked on this like a big project that's been going on for 15 years. Like every successful project kind of becomes a victim of its own success.
Yeah.
And in some sense, like the more the business is successful, you rack up technical debts, so, like you try to cover that with tests, and like you can cover that with money at a certain point, but at some point you gotta have the problem head on. And usually by that happens, like the monster has grown.
Manish, what are you seeing this? So, you know, as you're thinking about, you know, when you heard about Launchable and some of this, so is this the sort of problem that you're wrestling with as well?
No, absolutely, right? I mean, as you know, InfoStretch has been the digital first company since the beginning, and we've been driving automation from soup to nut. What we have seen is that internet much faster pace. They want change in the requirement. They want to develop new things. I would say much faster than we ever had. Now, testing is one cycle which actually slows a lot of things down. I think the time has come where our innovation cycle in terms of process itself, to take example of CI/CD itself, automation of testing itself has really, really matured. We have now strong platform for AI and automation. Now, how do you combine both of them together and try to reduce our whole SDLC cycle per, I would say, per storyline in terms of Agile world till how do you remove unnecessary failures? I think AI will play a huge role in that realm. And I would say Launchable is taking a really, really leap in that and solve that problem. I'm very, very excited.
And how do you get the data? I mean, one of the great challenges, everyone says, oh, let's just use more data. But, you know, if only data was neatly packaged and ready for consumption, and it so rarely is.
Yeah, so and then
you,
that's a
how do you clean that up?
That's when I thanked my past 15 years working on Jenkins, you know, because like with so many people in that ecosystem have built with so many integrations. And then another part of it is like, you know, thanks in part to this like amount of automation that we, you know, let's say we've driven collectively. Now, like a test has been run so many times. Like I still remember, like back in the days when I first started working in this field, tests only run nightly.
Yeah.
And then so in the span of like a whole month, maybe I get like a 30 test records. Like now it's almost like, you know, we run it almost every commit and certainly every pull request. So the amount of available data has like a, you know, skyrocketed in at least like a 2 or 3 order of magnitude.
So Manish, how do you think about this in terms of, you know, finding out what are the things to go run? I mean, as you wrestle, is this a challenge you see and how have you been addressing it, you know, to date?
I would say it depends on the maturity of the organization, right? I mean, how efficiently they are ready to expose data on one side of the world. On the other extreme, if you like, we are now going in the territory of producing new generation data. For example, we work with many healthcare companies and create biosensors. Now, we never had such data. Now, how do you produce, especially for testing? For example, like how do you do the ground truthing of those data?
Yeah, I think that's actually a great point. Like, you know, test used to be thought as this like a binary thing. Like many metrics, like often operational metrics and business metrics and other things that's useful for feeding the scoreity. And then, so those are also requiring some statistics and mathematical analysis. And that's, I think, one of the key innovations that's happening in the, you know, in the space of QA, in the broad sense of the QA.
Well, that actually leads to an interesting question, KK. I mean, it's one of the challenges and trade-offs is, you know, how much you cover. You can never test everything. It's always a matter, it's a judgment call. You know, what level of certainty are you willing to accept?
Yeah.
And how do you think about that? How do you think about the trade-offs and, you know, first of all, where do you focus your testing? And then how do you assess the consequences of an escape?
There are a couple of things, I think. That one is to try to quantify what they are doing, right? So when we say, you know, some failure could slip when we only test what matters, like exactly how much is that? You know, like, is that a worse, and then what improvements did that bring?